I think I was probably brought up in a very normal fashion. We did have a house. I do have brothers and sisters. I have wonderful parents, wonderful family, really very wonderful family. I think we're a very highly motivated family. But again, I would never use the word ambition. And because to me, ambition's a bad word. When I see people saying, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that and I'm so ambitious and I'm in it, it really sickens me to listen to them talking.
I've never seen anything to the extent that I have in New York. It now, from a real estate standpoint, has probably become the hottest city in the world. People are flocking here by droves. And I guess a lot of things had to do with it. Mostly, I feel it was the psychology of making New York a winner as opposed to a loser. Probably it's the greatest thing that the city ever did, and I think the city is the first to acknowledge it. They went overboard, they gave a tremendous break for the first time, actually in the history of New York, we got this commercial tax abatement. We took a building that had one person working, we now employ 2,000 people, and we employed during peak construction periods over 4,000 people.
And we congratulate Donald Trump today.
Thank you very much, Troy. I appreciate it. We've employed 5,000 construction workers. There'll be many people employed in running the building, and I think it's a very important step for New York. I think it's a vital step for New York. We're going to release 10,000 balloons, so have a good time.
When did you first get the idea for the Trump Tower?
We really had the idea about 3 years ago when we realized the site was available, and we wanted to do something great. And this is really how it all came about.
Oh, you really have. What was the economic situation in New York back then?
The economic situation for this location has always been great. Mm-hmm. In good times and bad times, Fifth Avenue and 57th Street has always really been very strong. You see it just in the play today. It's an exciting game. The people are going wild. The quality of the league has made it exciting. The quality of the players has brought 65,000 people out to watch a game in Birmingham, Alabama. I suspect that Bear Bryant might be looking down on the stadium right now.
Last year, it appeared that the USFL had a good plan A. They came out of the block strong. Big start. No plan B. Plan B looks like it's in place this year.
Well, I think last year, I disagree with the way it was handled last year, frankly. You know that. I've been very open. You really have to go out. You have to get the stars. Last year, it started off reasonably strong. This year, it's going to stay strong. You're going to see a very big week next week. You're going to see a huge week the following week. It's going to stay strong. It's going to stay strong for a long time.
All along from 72nd all the way down to 59th, we're going to have magnificent marinas, shopping, restaurants, everything all over the Hudson River.
How much trouble is the city giving you? How much trouble are our West Side community people giving you?
Well, trouble. I mean, what's trouble? I've had trouble all my life as far as that's concerned.
If you just decided I'm going somewhere else, I'm going to live in a trailer, and you wanted to sell off, and you wanted to sell off everything, you'd start with your real estate development, all of your real estate holdings, and whatever else you have, your casinos, so on and so forth. You sold everything.
Right.
How big would that check be that you put in your pocket when you headed west for the trailer?
Well, I hate to disappoint, but I have zero idea, David. How come this seat is at such a low level? You know, I'm looking at him. He's got this stage rigged, folks.
No, just, no. But give us...
That seat is a good half, six inches higher than my seat.
And so am I.
Huh? I see it.
I think that people should make a contribution and a major contribution, other countries, to this country for what we're doing to keep their freedom and to keep them free and to allow them to be free. And would you rather have that, or would you rather see this country to go totally bust in another couple of years? Because this country cannot afford to defend Japan and every other country in the world. It just cannot afford it.
It wouldn't be a tax. It would be more a payment in kind, like for landing space at airports, right?
It would be. You could call it anything you want. Yeah. To be perfectly honest, I don't care what it's called. But I think that Japan and all of these other countries should certainly pay. They can well afford to pay.
Are you a Bush Republican?
No, I think I'm really, the people that I do best with are the people that drive the taxis. You know, wealthy people don't like me because I'm competing against them all the time, and they don't like me, and I like to win. The fact is, I go down the streets of New York, and the people that really like me are the taxi drivers and the workers, et cetera, et cetera. I mean, I really get a great
response.
Why
are you a Republican?
I have no idea. I mean, I am a Republican because I just believe in certain principles of the Republican Party. I was with George Bush today. I listened to George Bush. I listened to what he said, and I believe very strongly in what he said. I think he is going to be a great president.
Why not the tour of the USA or tour of New England? Why not just drop the name Trump?
The problem is you wouldn't be here doing an interview right now. That's the problem. And we've gone over it, and I would have almost preferred if we could have done without. And somehow now it's been almost received beautifully. It's just been so successful and so nice, and the coverage has been so fantastic. A lot of the races came actually because of the name. So the name has been a plus, and Again, I wanted to be successful because that's important for the name.
Let's look ahead. 10 years from now, where do you feel the Tour de Trump will be?
I think that with a little maturity, with a little time, with a little effort, and with NBC's help, we'll make this the equivalent of the Tour de France.
They were supposed to take my helicopter, but they didn't want to wait for 2 hours because mine was coming back. So they rented a helicopter from an outside company that probably didn't know what they were doing and gone. Now, they call me and they say to me, I'm walking out of the office waving, we'll see you in an hour, we'll call you in an hour, do you want to come? And I'm almost saying yes, and I just decided I was too busy. You know, fortunately, I was doing something where I was busy. But they said, we'll call you in an hour. And then I get a call from one of the secretaries, Mr. Trump, they never showed up. Could you explain? Do you know where they landed? And you don't even think about it. You say, well, I'm sure they landed at maybe a different airport. They landed on the roof of one of the buildings where we have heliports on all the buildings. And then all of a sudden you get a call from the police saying, Mr. Trump, I'm sorry to inform you. And it is a shocker. But it showed me how fragile life is.
Just briefly, you conceive of a development in a site. It usually starts with a piece of land. You conceive of this. You go and you get your zoning, or you have your zoning. You get your architects, you get your engineers, you get your planners. You design something that you think is going to be nice and economic and all of the things that it's supposed to be. You then go out and get your financing, ideally. You used to go out and get your financing. Today you don't even think about it. You then go out and get your financing, you build your job, you hopefully have a success, and you've created a lot of jobs in between for lots of people that are buying lots of different things for the families, including other homes, et cetera, et cetera.
I watched Mike, and I've been with Mike, and I've seen him, and people really take advantage of this man. And I want to tell you something. I think this is one of those examples. Now, I know we have a system of juries, and I know we have a system where if you're found guilty, you're guilty. But somebody like me, maybe who has a little bit more independent streak, can say, hey, Mike Tyson, in my opinion, should really be given another break. I mean, they put him in jail before he was even guilty, as far as I was concerned.
Do you believe he'll fight again, and do you believe he'll ever be the heavyweight champ again?
I think he'll fight again. I don't know that he'll be the heavyweight champ again. In the prison that he's in, they don't allow boxing. That's a long layoff.
For whatever reason, you have a closed mind. I don't know why. Perhaps you could tell me.
No, Mr. Trump, I have a closed mind against evidence that is not substantiated.
Oh, well.
I have a closed mind against statements that are made about other people in general.
You're going to be very embarrassed in 2 years, sir.
You go on a radio show and you say, now some drunken Indians want to come down here and open a reservation.
I didn't say that, sir. Quote it. I didn't say that. Who said that? Who said that? I'd like an apology right now because I didn't say that.
Imus opened the broadcast, so excuse me. Mr. Imus said that.
Okay, could I please have an apology?
You can have an apology.
Thank you, sir.
It looks a little,
cheap?
Yeah, it looks cheap.
Yeah, you mean the amount of money?
Well, the amount of money...
Not so bad. Somebody gets married and it doesn't work out, you get $1 million. I mean, you know, and I think $1 million is a lot of money.
No, you don't.
No, I don't, actually, but...
Do you really think this is the right thing for us to be doing, Ivana?
What will people think?
Let them talk.
Tana.
Ivana. It's wrong, isn't it?
But it feels so right.
Then it's a deal?
Yes, we eat our pizza the wrong way.
Crust first.
Introducing stuffed crust pizza from Pizza Hut. With a ring of cheese baked into a totally new, thinner crust, you'll want to eat it the wrong way. Crust first.
May I have the last slice?
Actually, you're only entitled to half.
See you in the limo.
All right.
Hello? I told you not to call me on this line again. That's better. I will say that last year, before I owned the Miss Universe contest, I went to the Miss Universe contest last year. It was in Las Vegas. And I felt that Alicia was one of the most beautiful women I'd ever seen. It was incredible. And all of the folks that were here agreed with that. Alicia is like me and like a lot of other people. I love to eat. We all love to eat. Not all of us. Some of you are lucky. But we eat. We like to eat. And she had tremendous pressure put on her with the win and everything else. Plus, she was going from country to country, all foreign places. And there was a huge amount of pressure. And some people, when they have pressure, don't eat. And some people, when they have pressure, eat too much, like me, but like Alicia. And I'm not even sure that he shouldn't have just gone in and taken the Fifth Amendment and said, look, I don't get along with this man, Star. He's after me. He's a Republican. He's this, he's that. And, you know, just taking the Fifth Amendment. It's a terrible thing for a president to take the Fifth Amendment, but he probably should have done it. I don't think he could have
done any worse than what's happened. It's such an embarrassment to him. I mean, I see him walking around. It's like a terrible embarrassment.
And you think when you see him doing this, what comes to your head as a businessman about the miscalculation he made?
Well, it's just that there are so many miscalculations.
As you know, and the people in this room know better than anyone, putting money and investing money in Cuba right now doesn't go to the people of Cuba. It goes into the pockets of Fidel Castro. He's a murderer. He's a killer. He's a bad guy in every respect. And frankly, the embargo against Cuba must stand, if for no other reason than if it does stand, he will come down. He will tumble down, and it'll finally happen.
I'm not here to ask for Jesse's support at this point, because in all fairness to Jesse, I haven't even made the determination to run. If I do, I'll be back here very quickly, because there's nobody's support that I'd want more than his. But at this point, and as I said before in our speech, I'm not here for that. I'm here as a friend of Jesse, and I'm a big supporter of Jesse. I think he's done a great job, and I have a lot of I'm in Minnesota. I come to Minnesota quite a bit over the years. I know a lot of people that live here, and they love this man. He's done an amazing job.
It's a tough situation, but you can't give up hope, because there's always hope. I mean, the five men, I'm sure their families thought that they probably were gone, and now they walk in the door. A couple of them walked away after they were dug out. So there probably are some more people in there, and therefore you can't give up hope.
You've had an impact on the skyline of New York. What is it like as you see it now?
It's like a whole different skyline. It's like a whole different city and world. I cannot believe the sight of Lower Manhattan without the World Trade Center. And therefore, we have to rebuild, not necessarily in that form, but we have to rebuild at least as good and maybe better.
I put together some really impressive deals, but this thing you've pulled off, it's amazing. A big and tasty for just a dollar? How do you do it? What's your secret? You're a man of few words. I like that.
What is the problem with ice cream?
I have no idea.
It drips.
Okay.
So my idea is what?
To make a drip-proof ice cream.
No. Oh, that's a brilliant idea, this. All right, whatever. You ain't going to come out with that, though.
No, I promise you I won't.
Well, my idea is to come out with just like these ice cream gloves that make the ice cream not go on your hands and make it all well sticky. And also keep your hands warm.
Okay.
When you was eating the ice cream.
Okay.
Is you in or is you in?
Okay, well, it sounds like a good idea, and I hope you make a lot of money.
I'll tell you, to me, the second most important thing after love what you do is never, ever give up. Don't give up. Don't allow it to happen. If there's a concrete wall in front of you, go through it, go over it, go around it. But get to the other side of that wall.
What's that?
Whose tie is that?
Everything's a competition with you. Whose tie is better? Who's got the better tie? You're going down, O'Brien. I think your tie is very nice. I think, you know, who can say?
Do you want it?
Do I want your tie?
Yes.
Yes, I want your tie.
And you know, it's actually extra long for guys like us.
Very nice.
For tall guys like us.
Are you wearing a watch tonight? Because I'd like to have it.
I think Barbara will eventually fire Rosie. She can't stand Rosie. Now, Barbara's going to deny that, and I don't care. I mean, you know, maybe Barbara will never speak to me again. She didn't tell me to keep it quiet, or I would never reveal that. But during my conversation with Barbara, she called me last week. She said, Donald, I got to put up with it. I can't stand it. I hate it. Now, eventually, she'll get rid of Rosie. There's no question in my mind. This is a total catastrophe, and you might as well get out now because you're just wasting time and lives. You know, nobody talks about the soldiers that are coming back with no arms and no legs. And I saw at Mar-a-Lago on Mondays, I make Mar-a-Lago my club that you know about.
In Palm Beach.
I make that twice now. On a Monday, I let returning Iraqi injured soldiers come to the premises. The most beautiful people I've ever seen, but they're missing arms and legs. They're with their wives, sometimes they're with their girlfriends, and the tears are coming down the faces of these people.
I think a lot of the press is very dishonest. I think a lot of the press is really, really dishonest. But I think that I've been totally You see, most people think I get great publicity. I happen to think I get terrible publicity. So, you know, what can I say?
Do you mind what people write about you?
I used to mind much more.
Say about you?
I used to mind much more. The one thing I have learned, it's a one-week phenomena. It doesn't matter. At the end of a week, usually at the end of a day, but usually at the end of a week, it's totally gone. You don't even remember the story. And once you get that into your head, you can live with it.
That's my office.
Where's my office?
You got down the hall. Pretty nice. Not bad. I think you'll be okay with it. Who are you?
I'm Santina Marella.
What the hell are you doing here?
I work here. I'm Miss WrestleMania.
Let me just tell you something. I'm doing to you tonight the same thing that I did to Miss California.
What's that?
You're fired. Get out of here. Whether you like Ronald Reagan or didn't like Ronald Reagan, I mean, there was a level of respect for this country that we had.
You think President Obama doesn't have that? He's had periods where he's quite popular around the world.
Well, initially he was. I mean, certainly initially he was. But we cannot let the rest of the world beat us up. I mean, we're like a whipping post right now.
So if you ran, you'd run as a Republican, correct?
I am a Republican. I would run as a Republican, yes.
LaToya came to my office. She made a very strong case as to why she should be allowed back. And I respected that. You know, LaToya could have gone home to California. Yes. She could have taken it easy. She's got plenty of money. She's got a great lifestyle. She didn't want to leave.
Yes.
Never give up. People say, how do you be successful, Mr. Trump? One of the early things that I say is never, ever quit. Never, ever give up. Mm-hmm. So, LaToya, congratulations, you're back. You're going to be working with the men's team. Our country is in serious, serious trouble. Whether it's OPEC, the OPEC nations, or China, or virtually anybody that we do business with throughout the world, they take advantage of us, they laugh at us, they can't believe their good fortunes. I deal with these people, and they can't believe what they're getting away with. So we really have an opportunity to do something great for the country. And it's my honor, real honor, and privilege to endorse Mitt Romney.
And bring a little piece of Russia to you. You ready for this?
Go ahead.
Oh.
Well, now I put it up, I'll mess up my hair, but do you, huh?
You don't have to put it on.
No, it's so beautiful, AJ. I know your viewers want that sucker on, though.
Go ahead.
Wow, that is really...
You're looking very Russian.
That is really nice. Now I belong.
I just bought Turnberry, the Great Turnberry, home of the British Open, which they call the Open Championship because it's probably the most important of the majors. And it's just a great thing. And that's 1,000 acres on the ocean. And you just don't lose money with that. And the clubs do very well. I don't want to close it. I don't want to sell any, but it's great real estate. The other one minor thing too, I've made tremendous deals because of my relationship to golf. I play golf with people that love golf, and I become great friends with them. I have so many friends. I don't want to mention names.
Do you make deals on the golf course?
I make deals because of golf. I have so many wonderful friends.
The tax guy's getting in on this, yeah.
He used to call me on the cell phone.
And even tonight, with all of the heated back and forth between my opponent and me at the debate last night, we have proven that we can actually be civil to each other. In fact, just before taking the dais, Hillary accidentally bumped into me, and she very civilly said, "Pardon me."
We are eradicating the criminal gangs and cartels that have infiltrated our country. You're reading about them all the time. Some of you have big problems with them. Thank you for that sign. Blacks for Trump. I love that guy. Blacks for Trump. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, man. That's great. That's really cool. I appreciate it.
We have solutions that will pass the House and Senate right now
and will not shut down the government, and that's what we're urging you to do. Not threaten to shut down the government, because you, let me just finish, because you can't get your way.
The last time you shut it down, you
got killed. Yeah, let me say something, Mr. President. You just say, my way or we'll shut down the government. We have a proposal that Democrats and Republicans will support to do a CR that will not shut down the government. We urge you to take it.
And if it's not good border security, I won't take it.
It is very good border security.
And if it's not good border security, I won't take it.
It's what the
border... Because when you look at these numbers of the effectiveness of our border security, and when you look at the job that we're doing with our military...
You just said it is effective.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah, you just said it's effective.
Without a wall, these are only areas where you have the walls.
We want to do this.
Where you have walls, Chuck, it's effective. Where you don't have walls, it is not effective.
We thought we'd give you a update on the hurricane. We got lucky in Florida, very, very lucky indeed. We had actually our original chart was that it was going to be hitting Florida directly. Maybe I could just see that, Kevin. It was going to be hitting directly, and that would have affected a lot of other states. But that was the original chart, and you see it was going to hit not only Florida, but Georgia. It could have was going toward the Gulf. That was what was originally projected. And it took a right turn. After consulting with our top government health professionals, I have decided to take several strong but necessary actions to protect the health and well-being of all Americans. To keep new cases from entering our shores, we will be suspending all travel from Europe to the United States for the next 30 days. The new rules will go into effect Friday at midnight. These restrictions will be adjusted subject to conditions on the ground. There will be exemptions for Americans who have undergone appropriate screenings.
After this, we're going to walk down, and I'll be there with you. We're going to walk down. We're going to walk down. Anyone you want, but I think right here, we're going to walk down to the Capitol. And we're going to cheer on our brave senators and congressmen and women. And we're probably not going to be cheering so much for some of them. Because you'll never take back our country with weakness. You have to show strength and you have to be strong. I know that everyone here will soon be marching over to the Capitol building to peacefully and patriotically make your voices heard. Today we will see whether Republicans stand strong for integrity of our elections. And we fight. We fight like hell. And if you don't fight like hell, you're not going to have a country anymore. Believe me, she would not be my first choice, that I can tell you. Man. You don't know. That would not be my first choice.
When you said in that video that Ms. Leeds would not be your first choice, you were referring to her physical looks, correct?
Just the overall. I look at her. I see her. I hear what she says. Whatever. You wouldn't be a choice of mine either, to be honest with you. I hope you're not insulted. I would not, under any circumstances, have any interest in you.
One question about what happened when you had those documents.
It included a raid on my house. That's what it included.
They didn't raid. You'd gotten a subpoena and they had not been turned over yet.
They didn't raid Biden's house. You know what happened? They put him in the house. That's the one with the Corvette where the documents were laying all over the floor. That was fine. And you know who happens to be at Mar-a-Lago? Secret Service, and they're phenomenal. I have Secret Service. He didn't have Secret Service. The other thing, the vice president cannot declassify. He didn't have the right to declassify. He has documents from when he was a senator. And even Democrat senators say, I can't believe it. No.
That's the question that investigators have, I think, is why you held on to those documents when you knew the federal government was seeking them and then had given you a subpoena to return them.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Can I talk?
Yeah, what's the answer?
Do you mind?
I would like for you to answer the question.
Okay, it's very simple to answer.
That's why I asked it.
It's very simple to... You're a nasty person, I'll tell you.
I started to, like this, turn to my right and was ready to begin a little bit further turn, which I'm very lucky I didn't do, when I heard a loud whizzing sound and felt something hit me really, really hard on my right ear. I said to myself, wow, what was that? It can only be a bullet. And moved my right hand to my ear, brought it down. My hand was covered with blood, just absolutely blood all over the place. I immediately knew it was very serious, that we were under attack, and in one movement proceeded to drop to the ground. Bullets were continuing to fly as very brave Secret Service agents rushed to the stage, and they really did, they rushed to the stage.